Ask if they need a car pump or something like that.
I'm Matt. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you, Matt.
Hi.
Right.
It's, yep. They're all standing in line right now.
Okay. Sheila, is Langston guarding the can you tell me to wrap it?
I did. I already did that.
They can bring the book to the park and tell them
that. Sign
we will. We'll take
gathering was starting to celebrate the wedding of Ellen and David. I'm Reverend Royce, and I've been honored by a request from their heart to lend a hand and a heart to the throne of God this evening. On their behalf, I welcome you all to the church. Who gives this one to you? I do. As I bind these two spirits in the name of love, they wish to share their blessings with those people, both present and absent, who have been their angels, their guides, their teachers, their benefactors, and their friends. They wish each person here today to be touched by their joy and their faith in love. For in love shall we all find peace and be of one. Now, Mary Ferranto, go read.
This reading, chosen by Ellen and David, is taken from Paul's letter, his first letter to the Corinthians, chapter 13. If I speak in the tongues of men and angels, but have not love, I am only a resounding gong or a clanging cymbal. If I have the gift of prophecy and can fathom all mysteries and all knowledge, and if I have faith that can move mountains, but have not love, I am nothing. If I give all I possess to the poor and surrender my body to the flames, but have not love, I gain nothing. Love is patient. Love is kind. It does not envy. It does not boast. It is not proud. It is not rude. It is not self-seeking. It is not easily angry. Love keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. It always protects. It always trusts. It always hopes. And it always perseveres.
Now, dear friends, we have arrived at a point in our proceedings where, at the request of the bride and the groom, I have been encouraged to lay scriptures aside and establish protocol. And in their words, wing it, baby. So in service to that request, I will now flap my wings in all attempt to soar like an eagle, this done as I give it my very best to keep up with these two love. In case you haven't noticed as yet, this is all about love here today. From our little perch, here, we are basking. We are celebrating, and we are projecting. Can you feel it? Ellen and David stand before you, doing the one thing we humans can do so very well, surrendering to love. This is their reminder they are sending your way. They are turning on the green light. They are flashing you the high sign. They are encouraging you to come out on the dance floor. This is the gift they are giving to each one of us on this, their special day. We are happy that you are here and that you all came by to our little love depot to get your booster shot. Ellen and David are living proof that it will do your ticker a world of good, as it does our world the same. We are so happy. As we join this couple today, we now bring them together with David's children. And I would ask, do you, David, Matthew, Sarah, Joe, take Ellen to be a member of your family, to respect, to love, and to
we do. I am told that the Lord
I'm sorry, I know it's a strange way to tell you that I know we belong.
And simple, round like the sun, like the eye, and like arms that embrace, circles for love that is given to his back and his round again and again. There, may these symbols remind you that your love, like the sun, must illumine, that your love, like the eye, must see clearly, and that your arms that embrace is a grace. Thank you. autographed here in the park. You're invited to hit book.
Great.
Look at him. Yeah, this guy right here.
There you go.